And we're back. The Philippine government's chief lawyer formally asks the International Criminal Court to stop its probe into the country's drug war killings. Solicitor General Minardo Guevara submitted the request to the court's pre-trial chamber Thursday. That's after the tribunal's prosecutor office asked that it be allowed to resume its investigation. Guevara insists the ICC has no jurisdiction over the Philippines. He argues the alleged killings in the anti-narcotics operations could not be considered as crimes against humanity. Government also pointing out the complaints filed with the ICC are already being investigated and prosecuted in the Philippines. Human rights groups believe tens of thousands were killed in the anti-narcotics campaign of then-President Rodrigo Duterte, who withdrew the Philippines from the ICC in March of 2018. And we'll be speaking now with Solicitor General Minardo Guevara himself. Solicitor General, good afternoon. Thanks for joining us today and welcome to the program. Finally have you on the show.
Magandang tanghali, Carmina, at good afternoon to all your televiewers.
All right, so first, get ready because I have a lot of questions for you, Solicitor General. Why was this the necessary step for the government to take? Why was this the necessary action for the government to take? Let's begin with that, Solicitor General.
Well, Carmina, alam mo, we could have simply ignored yung request, no? For us to submit additional comments or observations. But we think that out of committee and out of respect also for the International Criminal Court, mas mabuti na siguro yung mag-submit tayo ng ating comments and our observations about the recommendation ng prosecutor. Mm-hmm. So ito yung opportunity kasi for the Republic of the Philippines to state very clearly kung ano ang position ng ating bayan, no, tungkol dyan sa binabalak na resumption ng investigation ng prosecutor ng International Criminal Court into the Philippine situation. So we felt na it's a lot better that we make an official statement of our position on the proposed resumption of investigation by the ICC prosecutor.
Mm-hmm. But you were Justice Secretary then when all of this began. Why couldn't have the country then, under the President Rodrigo Duterte's administration, why couldn't it have taken this similar stance when you were Justice Secretary, Solicitor General?
As a matter of fact, we have been consistent in our stance in relation to the ICC.
Mm-hmm. But can providing this comment, go ahead.
Pardon?
But providing this comment and submitting this comment, why wasn't this done then?
Well, it's simply for the reason that the matter has been brought to the pretrial chamber of the ICC by the prosecutor. Before, we had been dealing only with the office of the prosecutor. So out of committee and out of goodwill with this office, we submitted certain information. But now he has brought the matter to the attention of the pretrial chamber because he needed permission to resume his investigation after it was deferred for a few months. Mm. So it's now with the pretrial chamber at ang order or ang request ng pretrial chamber is for the Philippine government to submit any additional information or data. Kaya ngayon lang naman kami nagsasubmit because of the invitation extended by the ICC pre-trial chamber.
Mm, because the procedure now calls for it.
Exactly.
Okay. Now, in your comment, you said, Solicitor General, that the ICC has no jurisdiction over the situation in the Philippines. You say that the alleged murder incidents do not constitute crimes against humanity. So if they're not that, Solicitor General, and that they do not qualify as an attack on the civilian population, what would you call those deaths then?
Carmina, it's not an attack against the civilian population. It's an attack on unlawful illegal activities. So it's part of general operations against crimes, no? Kaya ang ina-attack dyan ng Philippine government is the existence of illegal activities, more specifically, the prevalence of drug offenses, no? Yun ang ina-attack. Hindi naman ina-attack yung population, no? In the sense that merong persecution on the basis of political, racial, ethnic, religious, gender, etc. factors, no? Hindi naman ganun ang konsepto niyan. Ang ating ginagawa ay ang pagsubpo sa prevalence of drug offenses in our country. So incidental na dyan sa pag-carry out niyang ganyang campaign ay merong namamatay sa proseso. So it's not an attack against the civilian population.
How would you then explain instances like Kian De Los Santos's death?
Well, yung kaso ni Kian De Los Santos has actually reached the court. At ang ating korte naman ay nagkaroon ng finding na talagang merong criminal liability yung mga accused na police officers. Kaya nga, they were convicted. So it's an example na pagka naman talaga makikita at may ebidensya na merong unlawful activity or unlawful act na ginawa ang ating mga police officers, sila naman ay kakaharapin naman nila ang necessary punishment for what they
do. Mm-hmm. Soljan, how much weight does the president's words have?
Again, pardon?
How much weight does the president's words carry?
The president's word?
Words, yes. In general.
I'm sorry, what president's word are we talking about?
If a president says something about anything, how much weight does that have?
Are you referring to President Marcos?
No, it's a general question. If a president says something, do we take that as a matter of policy already? Does a president's words carry so much weight?
Well, certainly he's the head of government, no? And whatever he says, we take it at face value. We presume that everything he says is with all sincerity and with the interests of the country in his mind.
Mm. So that when your former boss, President Rodrigo Duterte, ordered to shoot those who resist arrest in the drug war, when he told a senior police commander then that he is free to kill everybody in the name of the drug war, how could that not have been seen as a state order to commit such an attack, Soljan?
I think he had clarified his statement many times, Carmina. I think he had clarified those statements when he said that if your life would be in danger, then use the necessary force to ensure that you will be safe. So in other words, the general instruction is carry out your mandate in accordance with law. But if you find yourself in danger, if you would be under attack by the same suspects in your drug operations, then use the necessary force to repel that kind of danger or threat to your safety.
But to kill right away?
Well, he didn't say that. I mean, he qualified that. He clarified that. If somebody is pointing a gun at you, then what else do you need to do? Mm-hmm. You don't embrace him. You don't punch him.
You said in your comment as well, Mr. Solicitor General, that the situation in the Philippines is not that government is unwilling and unable to carry out the judicial proceedings. But when we talk about the timing, Solicitor General, can you honestly say that the cases were given attention when they needed it the most? That the families of these victims, when they needed the presence of government, the presence and protection of government, that you were there?
When all of these incidents where deaths occurred actually happened, it is automatic on the part of the PNP to conduct their own investigation with or without a complaint coming from the family of the victims. Mm-hmm. And the Philippine National Police Internal Affairs Service has examined all of this more than 6,000 deaths arising from operations of the PNP and other law enforcement agencies. Mm. Their conclusion based on their initial investigation was that the great majority of these cases did not show any irregularity or anomaly on the part of the law enforcement agents. So, however, they also found many cases, more than 50 cases, where they saw that their own law enforcement agents had committed lapses in their operations, which resulted in the deaths of certain individuals. That is why the PNP endorsed those cases to the Department of Justice for appropriate action. And in turn, the Department of Justice referred these cases to the National Bureau of Investigation so that the proper case buildup could be done. And true enough, the National Bureau of Investigation has found that several of these cases referred by the PNP would have enough evidence to sustain a finding of probable cause. That's why they have filed several cases already with the DOJ for preliminary investigation, and some of these cases have gone to court, and the police officers were accordingly indicted or charged.
When you were Justice Secretary then, Mr. Solicitor General, did you believe then that these deaths were alarming?
Well, it's rather alarming in the sense that there were so many, but it was an overall, a total comprehensive campaign throughout the country, because that was the cornerstone of President Duterte's campaign during the elections. And that was his number one objective, to eradicate as much as possible the drug problem. So this was an intensive, comprehensive campaign throughout the country. And it's really unfortunate that in the process, quite a large number of people died as a result of this police operation. But whether they were intentionally killed or whether they were killed in the process because they resisted, that is the subject of the investigation that is going on right now. Mm. That is what we're trying to find out. We want to find out how many of these cases involve intentional killing, and which ones were really as a result, quite unfortunately, of legitimate police operation.
And having said that, I take it to mean that you do not believe that these deaths are acceptable.
Well, you know, it's hard to generalize. There may be situations where the police were justified in actually having to pull the trigger. But there may be also occasions, and I admit that probably would lead one to conclude that the action taken by the police might have been excessive. Mm.
Who should be held accountable for these deaths then?
Well, definitely the police officers who were involved in those operations and who used unnecessary force leading to the death of certain people would have to be accountable. But we are hoping that in the process of investigation, they would be able to tell the other police officials, their superiors who might have given them specific orders. Mm. But, you know, that's part of the investigation. Right now, we've got to start with investigating certain people na talagang makikita mo na mayroong direct involvement. Mm-hmm. Now, in the process of investigation, it is possible that many other officials or police officers higher in rank may be involved, but we'll get there. We'll have to start somewhere. Mm-hmm. At ang unahin mo ay yung talagang those on the ground na siyang may involvement dun sa actual killing.
And if the evidence leads you to your former boss as one of those officials higher in rank, can the people actually rely on you that you will or expect you to file a case against him, given that you were once his alter ego, Mr. Solicitor General?
Well, it's the Department of Justice who should now prosecute, no? Kasi sila yung nagko-conduct ng investigation. The Office of the Solicitor General performs a different function. But I guess under the new administration, wala namang any signs na parang merong intention to cover up or something like that, no? So I suppose that we can put our trust that the new administration will have to pursue this investigation to its logical conclusion, to where it may lead.
What are your expectations now after you've submitted your comment? Do you think that your comment will sort of temper the environment now, and you're expecting the ICC to really see that, you know, the justice system here is working?
Carmina, that's what we're hoping. No? We trust in the fairness and in the impartiality of the three judges comprising or composing the pretrial chamber. So, pinakita naman natin sa ICC that we have been doing our responsibility of conducting our own investigation, and under the principle of complementarity, which underlies the very existence of the International Criminal Court, they should give priority or primacy to the domestic investigation that is ongoing. We do not have any reason to believe that this investigation is not genuine. It is very clear that the system is functioning kahit na ang resulta so far may not be up to par, in the sense na konti pa lang ang actually nakakasuhan sa court. Mm. But that's how our legal and judicial system works. Hindi naman yan as if merong na-file na kaso ngayon, bukas makalawa ay meron ka ng conviction na in-expect. Mm. What we are trying to show here is that we're doing what we need to do. Our duty, our mandate, we're doing it. So that's enough for us. And maghintay na lang sila ng resulta. Mm. Hindi naman tayo nagmumoro-moro dito eh. Mm. We're doing this investigation genuinely. Mm. We are not unwilling. We are not, you know, this is something that we are able to do on our own. Mm. Kaya yun naman siguro dapat i-respect din ng ICC. We are a sovereign country and our system is functioning. So if they come in, if they say that they have jurisdiction, that is an indictment not only against certain officials of the country. It's an indictment against the entire Philippine judicial and legal system. In effect, they're saying, you're not functioning, you're not worth it.
Mm. But if one way to further show that is to reinstate the membership of the Philippines into the ICC, I know the president has said his piece about this, but do you think that it would help that our membership be reinstated, or that we join the ICC once again?
Well, I don't think that's quite relevant to the issue now, whether we are a member or not a member of the ICC. What matters is that we are able to show that our own legal and judicial system is functioning.
Finally, Solicitor General, in a matter of days, the UN Human Rights Council will again convene. And judging from what happened back in 2020, the Philippines' human rights situation will again be scrutinized when they convene in a matter of days. How do you think they'll find the actions taken now by the current administration on the human rights situation here in the Philippines and the case before the ICC?
I think the current administration of President Marcos has already made a statement that the new government, the new administration, is willing to work and to cooperate with the Commission on Human Rights more closely. It's just that right now, no new appointments have been made for the CHR. But in due time, I guess the president will make his appointments to the CHR. And I don't have any reason to doubt his sincerity when he said that his policy will be to continue respecting human rights, and that his government will continue to work closely with the new Commission on Human Rights.
Solicitor General Menardo Guevara there joining us here in Dateline Philippines. Thanks for joining us today. Take care and you keep safe. Nice to see you.
Thank you, Carmina.